Alright, let's do this one last time. This is the Demoman, and this is the Moose Cannon, aka the Demoman's best primary weapon. And for the past 7 years, this has been the one and only primary of his that I've consistently used. I'm sure you know the rest. Cannonballs do not explode on impact, but cannonballs will push players back. Bombs have a fuse time of 1 second, but can be primed to explode just a little bit earlier. It's got plus 20% projectile speed, more or less, depending on who you ask, and I'll be honest, it's not the most consistent weapon that I've ever used. It's hard to aim, and the fuse is hard to time, and don't even get me started on trying to hit anything less than 50 yards in front of you, but I still love this weapon. So no matter how many shots I miss, and no matter how many times I die, I always end up coming back to it. Why? Because I just can't get enough of that double dunk.
Rumor has it that he got donked straight to the end of the video, but I mean, who really knows, right?
Yeah, I mean, maybe it's a good thing that he's gone, you know? I mean, now that he's not here, I don't have to spend the first 75% of this video talking about the double donk, and then the rest of it talking about cannon jumping, right before I highlight the fact that this is a bad weapon that's situationally useful, you know? And I don't have to do any of that now, I can just do whatever I want. Because I don't just want this to be a moose cannon video, I want this to be THE moose cannon video. I want to treat this weapon with respect! So, to set the stage for this video, I want you to take a look at something. And I'm sure when you look at this, you'll probably be asking yourself the question, BreadMann, why have you cursed El Maxo to roll a giant cannonball uphill for all eternity? I did it because he called the Moose Cannon TF2's best bad weapon, which is a crime worthy of punishment because bad weapons don't exist. And I don't really agree with videos calling weapons bad just because they don't fit one person's specific playstyle. Sure, I could sit here all day and tell you the stats and why they make the weapon bad, or I could sit here all day and tell you why the weapon is a less consistent downgrade from stock, or I could even sit here and tell you about how the double donk is the only thing that makes this weapon worth picking up because it plays a funny noise that makes me feel like Garfield 6 out of 7 days of the week. But if I did that, then truly I would be consigning both you viewers and myself to a game of checkers when we should be playing chess. Now, if I were a lesser content creator, I would perhaps take the attributes of the Moose Cannon and refine them into stats and practical uses while showing you how each of them compares to stock, perhaps in some sort of Venn diagram. But I'm not going to do that because this isn't Bad Weapon Academy, this is How to Properly Utilize a Weapon Based Off Its Design Philosophy Academy. You wouldn't judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, and you can't judge the Moose Cannon by its ability to have consistent damage output. Oh god, are we sure it's not a bad weapon? The Moose Cannon isn't a grenade launcher, so it can't be used or treated like one. But if the Moose Cannon isn't a grenade launcher, then what is it? I think I might have an idea of what it is, but just to know for sure, we're gonna have to go somewhere to get a second opinion. To the Mannputer!
Welcome to the Mannputer. How may I assist you?
Something you tend to hear a lot in this type of video is that there are two types of weapons in Team Fortress 2, hitscan and projectile based, and every time I hear that it hurts me just a little bit inside because that is a gross simplification of the weapon system, and I want to build on that. That's why I've taken you to the Mannputer, to help you realize how many different qualities a weapon can actually have. Mannputer, I need you to analyze the Moose Cannon and tell me exactly what it is.
The loose cannon is a second weapon.
Exactly as I thought, Mannputer. Thank you for the analysis, and leave the rest to me. And to you viewers, I promise that there's not too much distance between the leaps in logic we're about to make. Distance over time, that is. As in velocity, And speaking of velocity, what do you suppose would happen if a 20-pound cannonball traveling west with a velocity of 200 meters per second comes flying at a 300-pound heavy traveling east with a velocity of 0.02 meters a second? How many newtons of force would be felt at the moment of impact? See, the answer doesn't actually matter, because by the time you figure it out, the heavy will either be 50 feet in the air or halfway across the map, because upon a direct hit with the moose cannon, the enemy will suffer from knockback proportional to the distance the cannonball traveled before hitting the target. Which is probably the most practical and easy to understand feature of this weapon. Is your enemy standing just a little bit too close to the edge of a cliff? Off he goes. Need somebody off the objective? The loose cannon has you covered. Maybe you just need to disrupt the enemy's game sense of flow for a minute. Well, luckily for you, that's exactly what knockback was designed to do. Let's just move this soldier 8 feet to the left and let him figure out the rest before his health bar reaches zero. And I'm sure you've heard that the goose cannon is the absolute king of denying Ubers, and while that's absolutely true, it's kind of an understatement of the true ability here. Sure, if all you want to do is keep that Ubered heavy pushed back, then that's perfectly fine, but if you simply change your focus from the patient to the medic, there's an interesting change. All of a sudden, the goose cannon goes from Uber denier to an AMD, or anti-medic device. While keeping the enemy back is good, if you can break the med beam, you've done something infinitely more useful. For example, what if that medic happens to be using the Kritzkrieg? Hitting that soldier with some knockback won't really stop you and your team from dying, but if you can break the beam and send the medic out of the fight, then that solo charging soldier seems just a little bit less threatening. And really, you can apply this logic wherever you see a medic, no matter what he's doing. If the beam is broken and the medic needs to relocate, then you've given yourself a massive advantage. But these are just the direct consequences of the fantastic knockback the goose cannon carries. The indirect consequences include things like space management. Now, space management is essential for the non-melee demo man. Generally, the demo's primary and secondary weapons aren't exactly the best at super close range. And that's twice as true for the loose cannon, so if you can't keep your enemies at a distance, then you're probably in some trouble. However, if you're using the loose cannon how it's meant to be used, and trying to get those double Ds that shall not be named until the end of the video, you should already be hitting direct hits and indirectly keeping your enemies at a nice distance. But when it comes to true and effective space management, you need to not only consider where your enemy is in relation to you, but where you are in relation to your enemy. That's where cannon jumping comes in. With the power of cannon jumping, I start and end my fights wherever I want. First, I jump to the back line. Then, I miss all my shots, and before the enemy team even knows I'm there, I'm already flying back to spawn for more health. In reality, cannon jumping isn't all that different from sticky jumping. It lets you flank, it opens up escape options, and allows for some pretty cool rollouts. What makes cannon jumping an actual viable option over stickies, though, is speed. If you need to make a quick escape, it's a lot easier to use the shot that's already loaded in your cannon rather than switch weapons and prime a bomb. Overall, the loose cannon is to the Demoman what the detonator is to the Pyro, which you might not be surprised to hear is also my favorite Pyro secondary. It's actually insane how similar these weapons are. Little damage, conditional mini crits, allows for easy repositioning, entry and escape, and of course, the invaluable ability to control when and where your explosive goes off. When all of this is on the table, what other conclusion can you come to than the loose cannon is a secondary weapon? And I cannot stress enough that that's not a bad thing. See, weapons in Team Fortress 2 were on a coin of sorts in the... I'm sorry guys, I think my phone's ringing.
Yeah, hi, thanks for taking my call, BreadMann. How did I get your number? Don't worry about it. My question is, I hate the loose cannon, because it's a bad weapon. And listening to you talk about how it's in the very nature of TF2 to always be switching your weapons based on the weapons of your opponent, because your weapons are a coin. I mean, on one side, any given subclass or side grade will counter and do better against some classes than others. And on the other side of that coin, different kits will do better against yours. It's up to you to be knowledgeable and skilled enough to make a quick decision to counter your enemies. And it's up to your enemies to do the same to you. But personally, I think that's stupid. And so are you. Stock is a million times better, and it comes with a copy of 1997 3D Ultra Mini Golf. Whenever I see a player with a loose cannon, I know it's because they're new and don't know any better. But I do. I saw Lazy Purple's review of it. I watched El Maxo's video. You're only using that weapon because of the donk and we all know it. It's not actually good. You're lying.
Okay. Alright. Well, thanks. Before we get any other guest appearances, why don't we review everything that we've talked about so far, huh? First up, the Moose Cannon is not a grenade launcher. It's a secondary weapon, or a utility weapon that uses high movement in conjunction with what I'm coining alternative defense, or non-lethal defense. In other words, as a great computer once said, the Moose Cannon is a low damage, high movement, crowd controlling, defensive, accuracy rewarding, projectile based weapon. And I think that covers about everything. But I just can't shake the feeling that I'm forgetting something. Oh my god. The missing Pyro.
Behold the power of the dark.
Finally, the missing Pyro once again joins the video, giving me the perfect excuse to finally talk about the donk. And the truth is, I've been avoiding it this whole video, but I love the donk. There is no pleasure more great than being able to let the enemy know how badly they've been donked. Get donked.
I got out donked. I got out donked.
Just to listen to the beautiful music of someone getting donked.
Okay, but this time, you're gonna get it for sure, alright? What? God damn it!
Donked on.
No! Didn't donk! Didn't donk.
Get donked on, nerd.
No. Okay, here, watch this. Alright, you ready? Okay. Actually, you did donk on. No, I mean, you didn't donk on.
Get donked on, idiot!
God damn it! Shut up!
Observe as I eradicate this team of friendlies with the power of my donk! The way they were all standing still, they never stood a chance.
Get
donked
on. Shut up! You didn't even get a donk!
Oh, sorry. Get donked on.
You didn't get a donk!
Dominated by the donk,
there
I guess.
There was no domination!
And this isn't even my clip, but the quadruple donk here is absolutely insane. Okay, why don't we just forget everything that we just talked about in the last 10 to 15 minutes or so? Forget everything you just heard, and let me rephrase all of it. Let me tell you about the Moose Cannon in a way that you as a Team Fortress 2 player might understand just a little better. Yeah?
Hey, look, buddy. I'm a demo man. That means I like explosions. Not explosions like those from the grenade launcher or the iron bomber, because that would fall within the purview of your conundrums of philosophy. I just kinda like the Moose Cannon. For instance, how am I gonna stop some big mean mother hubbard from tearing me a structurally superfluous new behind? The answer? Use a donk. And if that don't work, use more donk. Listen, what I'm trying to say is, I like my Moose Cannon, and if you ever see me using it, you best hope that I don't point it at you.